genocide of 1915 to 1923 became the blueprint for modern mass murder. An entire nation targeted for death. An unarmed population and inconvenient people destroyed by an empire. Men massacred, women and children deported to their deaths in the desert. A nation ripped from its homeland. A civilization nearly destroyed. An entire culture almost erased from the earth. A crime committed with impunity, denied for a century, consolidated without consequence. Bullied, bartered, or bribed into silence, the world turned away. Turkey emerged stronger for the crime, building great alliances upon its newfound power, leveraging its control to cover up its crimes. Armenians struggled just to survive. The truth buried among the crumbling ruins of a vast, now barren, landscape of death. Justice was left then to a handful of survivors who took it into their own hands. And today, to a reborn nation that demands a truthful and just international resolution of the Armenian genocide. A peaceful, global movement that's working to end the worldwide cycle of genocide and build a better future for Armenians and Turks based on truth and justice. This international effort has been joined by courageous women and men within Turkey who, at risk of prosecution and persecution, are rising above hatred and openly calling for recognition and reparations. They are few, but fearless. They are waking up the souls of their own system, their own society, their own history. They have chosen. Now it's time for us to choose, for the world to choose. Stand with these brave souls seeking justice for genocidal crimes, or side with the states that seek to silence them.
Thank you. flawless, and now you're police that know.
Thank you. See ya.
Thank you.
Oh, Why? In the sky, all is nothing, pain, and the walking of the them push us around anymore.
On the eve of his 1939 invasion of Poland, Adolf Hitler silenced those who dared voice reservations about his genocidal plans by asking, "Who now remembers the Armenians?" Inspired by the example of openly committing mass murder with impunity, he became the architect of a new genocide, the Holocaust. Nazi Germany's evil campaign to rid Europe of Jews, Poles, Gypsies, gays, the disabled, and all those who did not fit into Hitler's twisted vision of a pure race. Though the perpetrators of the Holocaust were defeated and punished, and the crime itself given a name and an international treaty, the cycle of genocide survived the horrors of World War II and continues to this day. In Cambodia, East Timor, Rwanda, Darfur, and too many other killing fields across the globe. Despite all the talk and all the treaties, the terror persists. In Africa, Asia, the Middle East, the world just stands back and watches. Today, a century after 1915, Turkey obstructs justice for the Armenian genocide. Neo-Nazis in Europe deny the Holocaust. Omar al-Bashir, the leader of Sudan, a mass murderer indicted for genocide by the International Criminal Court, travels the world in freedom. We can no longer sit back and watch these dreadful acts committed around the world. The time has come to wake up the soul.
Thank you.
Take my baby, take my baby, go. I need you high, really high.
the time you were alone. So you want to see the show, but they don't have to be from the time you were alone.
Such a lonely day, and it's
it's March. The most loneliest day of my life. Such a lonely day should be banned. It's a day that I can't stand. The most loneliest day. Such a lonely day shouldn't exist. It's a day that I'll never miss. Such a lonely day, and it's hard. The most loneliest day of my life. And if you go, I wanna go with you.
Thank you. Oh,
should have never come to Hollywood. They'll find you to time you. Say you're the best they ever see. You should have never come to Hollywood.
Thank you.
Bystander states enable atrocities. Arm killers. Profit from perpetrators. On their balance sheet of bullets, barrels of oil, their military bases, human lives are wound in air. The cycle of genocide serves state interests and will only stop when citizens make it change. Our governments will respond to genocide as a political commodity, trading away records, giving away reparations as long as we can. They will only challenge genocide as a moral imperative when we force them. For as we start to heal the wounds of this terrible crime, we begin the work of a world without genocide. Join us as we wake up the soul.
Advertising's got you on the run. Thank you. and those heathens will fight us, because we are both God and the devil all in one. We are our own worst fucking enemy and our own best friend. I want to say thank you to Moscow. The Russian parliament for being one of the first and early countries to pass the Armenian Genocide Resolution. Thank you very much for that.
Much bigger than yours.
Now, somewhere between us and the silence, and the silence is sweet.
No music!